Well, thank you, Chad. And it's really an honor for me to be here today to be able to address you county commissioners and council members. You know, it was back on January 9th of this year that a dozen of Utah counties came together to forever change the worldview of county government with a bold new television program that thinks outside the box in both content and approach.
Funded primarily by the counties themselves, the county seat has captured the attention of local, state, and federal leaders. With the airing of the 38th episode this weekend, the county seat will have covered the most controversial issues confronting Utah's county leaders, along with a number of stories that have taken the mystery out of what county government is and how you, as leaders, function. However, there is still a lot to cover as the second season quickly approaches. The biggest challenge facing the program is an easy one to solve, but we need your help. Some counties have asked why they should support the county seat. Well, there are many answers.
It's a forum for all counties to be able to get together and make themselves heard. And it provides strength when we all come together and talk about these issues.
It gives us an opportunity to get our side of the story out. And, you know, we don't have a big press machine to do that. And so this is a good opportunity for us to get before an audience different than what we normally get before.
And it helps to educate, I think, us, if we would look at it that way, to how can we better support some of those counties that have the issues in their front yard, so to speak, that do and will impact us.
There is some question among the counties as to the effectiveness of the program and viewership.
You know, it's refreshing to me when I hear people come forward and say, you know, I heard about this issue on the county seat. I've always wondered what the position was of other counties on these issues.
The program is gaining viewers on the several Utah television stations where it airs. Just as important as to how many people are tuning in is the fact of who is tuning in.
The fact that you're out there, you know, amplifying the message of county government and explaining what's taking place, I think is a godsend for the people of Utah. And I just wish you were on the air when I was a county commissioner.
Similar comments of support have come from Representative Rob Bishop, Jason Chaffetz, Senator Mike Lee, and several of Utah's state senators and legislators. In order to have the most impact possible on this important audience, we need the counties to participate more actively.
I would liken it, the value of it, to the old pitch back from childhood days when you would throw a baseball into the net and it would put it back to you. That would be true of the county seat program. If we are going to make it be all that it can be and make it be the most benefit that it can, we need to put some effort into it.
The county seat is a tool for the counties to get their message out to their constituents, legislators, and anyone else they are trying to reach.
Think beyond the immediate airing. Think beyond that in saying that, okay, now you have access to a library of issue-specific content that if you have a group of people that are interested in a particular area, that you can say, okay, here's some information on that.
It would have been nice when I was a county commissioner to have a show like the county seat that explains what the counties are about, the services they render. We're sometimes, you know, the best kept secret we have in government. There's those county officials out there that are doing so much of the hard work.
And I'm proud to say, for the county seat, I'm Terry Wood.